Hey, so I chose the term Emily Ruete, known as Salam Bin Said. She's a princess on Zanzibar. She went through a lot of difficulties throughout her childhood and early adulthood life. Mostly throughout her life, she went through a lot of difficulties and challenges. That when it gets her culture, her the social norms during that time, and yeah. So she was born on August 1844. She's also known as Sayyida Salam. She was the youngest child of 36 children of Sayyid Said bin Sultan Obu Said, Sultan of Zanzibar and Oman. She was the first Arab woman to write an autobiography with details about her life as a princess. There shows that. Salam broke the tradition of a female education by teaching herself how to write. An event that pretty much, in my opinion, changed her life was when her father died in 1856, in which Majid, her older brother, inherited the throne. Now, in my essay, I only talk about her two brothers. I did not include that she had 36 siblings because I didn't think it was irrelevant. I believe that I only wrote down the main details of her, and I felt that only talking about both of them would be, relevant. So, the reason I talked about only Majid and Barkash was because there was sort of like a revolution between her two brothers. Her other brother, Barkash, was very upset in a way and secretly was taking power because, like most of their siblings, she sided with him and became his general secretary at the age of 15 since she taught herself, how to write. She was writing letters to chiefs who decided to follow Barkash, but Barkash's insurrection ended really quick once, Majid found out. And Salam surrendered to Sultan Majid and lost support of all her siblings. She was alone. They sent her to this house that, they had or whatever. But that house was next to a young German merchant of the name of Rudolf Henrich Ruette. And she was they fell in love. She was very drawn into the Europeans of Zanzibar. She was very interested in how they lived, like the difference between, the Germans and the people of Zanzibar. Their affair did send shockwaves both to the royal family and the foreign trading company in Zanzibar. That is why, the Germans were able to stay there. Let's see. So it was later known that she was, pregnant, so she had to flee the country, and her stomach was getting noticed, so that's why she believed it was, getting too dangerous for her. Unfortunately, she did have a miscarriage, and once she was, in Germany, she that's when she married Rudolf Ruette, and then that's when, she changed her name to Emily Ruette, so people won't distinguish who she is, and she also religion to a Christian, and that was a big deal during that time, especially if she went against, the Muslim rules and laws. So, yeah, she went through a lot, and she was in a way alone, even though she had Rudolph. It you're in a strange land, and you don't know anyone besides one person, and it's really, and you're also learning a different language, so it's like really scary too. So let's see. So they both had three children. Ruette challenged the dispute. Once, when she was living there, she challenged the dispute called this beforehand in old prejudice. She noticed the injustice and blind stereotypes between, you know, the West and the East, because she did live through both cultures. So, after her youngest child, her third child, a tried stroke because her husband passed away. Now, he didn't have any backup. They both did not have any backup money. He didn't have money saved up or anything like that. And, you know, once again, she was in a strange land, and now she was penniless. So that's when she decided to write a book about her tragic and colorful life. It's just, you know, crazy how a woman, you know, is all alone in a country that she doesn't really know. She didn't grow up in that land either, and has to go against, you know, the social norms, the culture. People just look at her strangely just because of her skin tone and her background and everything, and not really having family anymore, because, you know, siblings didn't support her at all, and she kind of just vanished in a way from everyone. She only had her children and, you know, the house that she did have during that time. I consider her as a strong woman, and the beliefs of wanting to change the social norms. She went through a lot, and in a way, I do admire her. She's, you know, a pretty cool person if I was to ever, you know, meet her. But I hope you learned something new about her, and hope you enjoyed this video. So, thank you.